If you want to make cool clips like this, stay tuned for today's tutorial on Sora AI, an AI video generation app brought to you by the creators of ChatGPT. By the end of this video, you'll know how to create your first video on Sora, how to tune your prompts to get the best results, and how well Sora does at generating 6 different types of videos. Plus, stay tuned for our bonus content on adjusting camera, style, and lighting to get the right look and feel. Now, to access Sora, click the card at the top or use the link in the description. Let's dive in. From the homepage, click on the login button in the top right-hand corner. From here, you can use your username and password associated with your OpenAI or ChatGPT account. If you don't have an account yet, click sign up. Once you log in, you have to choose a paid plan because video generation ain't cheap. And before you think you can skip this step, not choosing a plan just gives you access to view other people's videos. So if you want to create videos, these are your options. The Plus plan is basically for play, because you aren't doing any commercial work at 720p. Plus, all of your videos are watermarked. Now, contrary to what this list says, at the time of filming, you can generate 10-second videos as long as your resolution is 480p. The Pro plan, on the other hand, is for serious users. And my job in this video is to help you see if that's worth it. And also, at the time of filming this video, OpenAI has granted unlimited relaxed videos to Plus users as well. So if you run out of credits to make videos, you can still create them. They'll just be slower to make. So subscribe to Plus or Pro, and I'll see you in the app. Once you're here, come join me in your videos collection by clicking on the All Videos link in the sidebar. This page contains all of your video creations. Let's start with something very simple to create your first video. First, click on the prompt box at the bottom of the screen. Then type in the following prompt: Star Wars style stormtroopers invading a modern office, pastel theme. We are not even going to worry about the other options right now. Press the enter key or click the white arrow to submit your prompt. And even in the relaxed queue, it only took about 30 seconds to generate. So Sora created 2 variations for us. Let's click on the first one to play it. Now, you can press the space bar at any time to pause the video. Here we've got the stormtroopers in a funky pastel office, but no office workers to speak of. Let's look at the next video by pressing the right arrow key. This one was a bit more dynamic because we had 2 different rooms that we're running through. But again, the desks are mysteriously absent their office workers. So let me show you something that you're going to do a lot of with any AI, and that's iterating on the result. Go to the bottom of the screen and click on the remix button. To add office workers, here's the prompt. It's very simple. Add office workers looking frightened at the invasion. Now, before we submit this, let's go through these options, starting with remix strength. Click on where it says strong remix. The higher the strength, the more likely things will change in the video, regardless of whether you asked for that change or not. Let's change the strength to mild so there are noticeable changes, but not over-the-top changes. The other 2 settings are pretty self-explanatory. Here's video resolution, and I always recommend playing with 480p before going up. It'll keep you moving fast while you're still experimenting. And then this option is the number of variations. 2 videos is a happy medium, so let's stick with that. Let's make one more change to the prompt to nudge Sora to put those office workers sitting at their desks. Now click on remix. Once it's complete, click the X in the top left and then the OpenAI logo to return to your videos. Now I've created a few more variations so you can see the differences in remix strengths. Let's start with the mild remix. This time, just hover your mouse over the video frame to play them both at the same time. Did you catch the office worker? You'll see it slowly appear on the left side of the frame on video 1. Note that you can scrub through the video by hovering your mouse and moving from left to right or right to left. The next generation was a strong remix. How many differences can you notice? Already we see there are more office workers and slightly different room setups, especially on the second video where a new hallway has appeared. And on the last one, I turned the remix strength up to its maximum of 8, and I changed the prompt to add office workers cowering in fear. So let's take a look at the differences. Again, the room setup is quite different in both of these videos, and there are more office workers, but you don't really get the sense of fear that we were going for. So the game here is prompt and adjust and adjust and adjust and so on. Now let's say you like one of the videos you created and you want to save it, like this one. Check out the icons in the top right-hand corner. You can add a video to your favorites list, you can share it with others via a link, you can download it to your desktop, or you can add it to a folder, which is basically like organizing your favorites. Let's head back to your home screen. And congratulations, you've just generated your first set of videos. You can see your favorites by clicking on the favorites link in the left sidebar, and you can create folders by clicking on new folder. Let's now cover how to make prompts to get exactly what you want out of Sora. The best place for inspiration is the feature tab, which you can access by clicking on the featured button in the left sidebar. Now remember the saying, good artists copy, great artists steal. Once you find a video that you like, you can click on it and view the prompt used to create it down below. If you want to edit it for yourself, you can also click on the prompt and view all of the settings associated with it. Not just the text itself, but also the aspect ratio, quality, length, and so on. If you don't want to mess with it quite yet, you can save it by clicking on the heart icon in the top right of the screen to like it. This adds the video to your liked videos, which you can access by clicking on the OpenAI logo in the top left, and then clicking on the likes button in the left sidebar. This is a great place to store videos that you see from other people that inspire you to create your own. Now that we've got some inspiration, let's go over some quick tips and tricks for your own prompts. Tip number one, keep it simple. Remember, it's not a movie creator, it's a clip creator. So when we ask Sora to create a cat surfing the waves in Hawaii, getting caught in a 50-foot swell, hanging 10 on the edge of the board, then riding to the top of the wave before coming into shore, it's not going to work that well. Generally, the more you ask for, the less you're going to get. Let's take a look. No 50-foot swell, no tricks, and no shore, but two tails. And of course, the cat is actually surfing, which is the main goal of the prompt. On to tip number two, avoid complex object interactions. You might not think that a guy eating a plate of pasta is that complex, but let me show you this. Check out the fork head dangling in the pasta. And on this one of the fork heads is melting. So if you keep these two tips in mind, there's a pretty simple formula to get what you want. You can remember it with the acronym CAST. C is for character. Who or what are the characters in the shot? A is for action. What are those characters doing? S is for setting. Where are the characters? And T is for time. What time of day or time period are they in? You can even ask ChatGPT to give you some ideas. I'll include this prompt in the description below. Here's an example of a prompt inspired by a ChatGPT response. The output's pretty good because we kept it simple. With the CAST acronym, we've described the what, but we haven't described the how. We'll open our prompt again by clicking Edit Prompt. This time, I'll click on this control panel icon next to the plus icon. This allows you to set and create presets. The easiest way to describe a preset is to show you how they're defined. You can do that by clicking on Manage. Here you see each preset describes several characteristics of the ending footage. For example, the color grading, camera, film stock, lighting, vibe, and so on. Let's click Done here, and just to illustrate how this works, we'll rerun this prompt on the mischievous fox with a film noir preset. We'll click the arrow to submit the prompt, and then we'll go back to the main queue. And now our stage with a playful fox has turned into a 1940s crime drama. There's a lot more to cover in terms of the camera, color grading, and film. We'll cover that more in the bonus content, so stay tuned till the end to get access to it. Here's the last tip. Don't be afraid to try again and again and again. We submitted the same prompt about a dozen times to get the clip from the start of this video. For this next part of the tutorial, I'm going to cover 6 types of videos and see how well Sora generates each of them. Starting with number one, B-roll. As a review, B-roll is any footage that supports telling your story, but isn't of the main scene. For each of these categories, I'll show you clear examples of what Sora generates along with the corresponding prompt, like this one, which is an establishing shot downtown present day. Now it does look pretty realistic in the top half of the video, but then you see the nonsensical road signs, the cars running into each other, and you think, maybe this isn't so good. Here's another alternative on the same shot. Again, not so bad, but you have the same problem with both the road signs and the traffic lights this time. Here's the next shot of downhill skiing. These environments feel very real, even if the quality of the skiing is not quite Olympic level. Here's another example going faster downhill. Here's the next shot, a high angle time lapse of a busy outdoor market. And now you start to see one area where Sora struggles. See, objects seem to just fade into each other. Watch this van that just appeared. It goes through people without consequence. Here's a slightly more credible shot, but it still has the same problem. Let's give Sora a chance to redeem itself where there's not a lot of action. This one I think almost works, except for one thing. The team is supposed to be drawing the user interface for their new app, but it's completely illegible. Maybe it's a detail you don't really need. So because of that, I'm gonna give Sora 3 out of 5 stars for B-roll. Next up is animations and abstract art. And here's the first prompt, particle simulation with fractal patterns. Honestly, I feel Sora does this pretty well. Here's another video to compare it with. Next, we're moving on to a lino cut. And this is a great reminder that you can use any terms you know from art, from printing, or cinematography to great effect with Sora. Sometimes with illustrations, you want them to be able to loop seamlessly, and we can do that using the loop command down at the bottom toolbar. Here you select a section of the clip that you want to loop. So we'll start it at the beginning and then stop it around here. Now we need to keep our 720p videos to under 5 seconds, which means I need to change the loop settings. A normal loop requires 4 more seconds to complete it, and a short loop requires 2. Now realistically, 2 seconds does not give Sora enough time to do a great job, but we'll check out what it sees. It's just completed, so let's head back to all of our videos and then scroll up to the top. Here's the loop. What do you think? Not too bad. Let's finish this category up by looking at some examples of light leaks. Here's number 1. And number 2. We've got some beautiful patterns here, and I think the lino cut would have done better with more time on the loop. So I'll give animations and abstract art 4.5 stars out of 5. Next up is the category of data and infographics. If you've ever tried to generate images with text in them, you probably know where this is going. So let's start off with an animated line graph, and I don't even know what this is. It's some sort of three-dimensional plot where nothing makes sense. Maybe the infographic will be a bit different, so let's take a look at that. And it's really not much better. Notice the prompt talks about 25,000 chimney fires, and Sora has completely changed the number. If you're looking for this kind of video, you're better off with other tools. Now, one other video that's in this category is a heads-up display, and this is where Sora redeems itself, sort of, because it can keep the focus on the action as opposed to all the misspellings in the display. But once it gets too busy like this, then the magic starts to disappear. So that leaves the data and infographics category with a paltry 0 stars. Next category is celebrities, and it should be very obvious that this is not going to work. But just in case you were curious, this is what you get when you ask for Beyoncé dancing. Also this. Of course it's not Beyoncé, it's just inspired by her. Let's try something else. Here's Steve Jobs riding a horse. Except instead of Steve Jobs, it looks eerily like Ewan McGregor from Trainspotting. This category is so bad, we're not even gonna rate it. Next up is fantasy, and this is for all you creatives in the audience. Here's an example of combining different types of animals together. The head of the monkey, antlers of a reindeer, and the body of a porcupine. Sometimes you get artifacts in the video like this one, so you have to keep an eye out for them. Here's another rendering of this same prompt. Here's another creative clip of an origami crane. See how the prompt just goes on and on, but there's no possible way that you can do all of that in 5 seconds. Keep that in mind for your own prompts. And to wrap up this category, here are some sandboarding hedgehogs. Now with the fantasy category, your creativity is the limit. We're much more willing to forgive mistakes when we know that the scene's not real. So I'm gonna give this category 4 stars out of 5. Last up is whether this is a fun tool for kids to use. In this category, we'll not only consider prompts, but we'll also show you how to upload your own characters. First up, you can make fun animations of characters interacting with each other. Well, sort of interacting with each other. We see again that interacting with objects is a challenge for Sora. So let's try something new. Instead of writing another prompt, let's upload our own character. You can upload photos to jumpstart your prompts by clicking on the plus button in the prompt box and then selecting upload image or video. First, you need to agree to 4 things: that you won't upload people under the age of 18, that you won't upload explicit content, that you have all the rights to the media you upload, and that misuse of this feature could get you banned. Next, click accept. And if you're watching this, you probably won't be able to upload media containing people either. After all that, you can upload your photo. Now you can add a prompt if you want, or you can let Sora animate the image on its own. Let's make everybody dance and submit the prompt. Here's the problem though. Popeye, even though it's just entered public domain, has somehow triggered some of OpenAI's copyright checks, so we're not able to see the result. This is going to happen for 99% of the characters that kids are familiar with. So that only leaves us with 2 choices: pictures of cats and memes that are cartoons. Neither of which are that great, although they can be fun once in a while. And that's why we'll give Fun for Kids 1 star out of 5. Now after all that, if you're still on the fence about a subscription, check out our bonus video in the top right on adjusting the camera, style, and lighting to your heart's content. This is David, and I'll see you there.